In this video, I discuss the various MCQ of the load analysis of the refrigeration and air conditioning system. Load analysis means it is the calculation of how amount of the heat is removed from the certain space. It is called as the load analysis. That is a load is generally two type. Okay, that is a sensible as well as the latent. Because the something inside the rooms or a house or a mall or a theaters are create the sensible heat and latent heats. Okay, so we also discuss that types of the topic. Now sensible heat load. First option, rise the dry bulb temperature of air in a condensed space. Condensed space means it is anything. It is our room, it is theater, it is the mall, it is the operation theater in the hospital. Rise the specific humidity of the air in condensed space. Rise both dry bulb temperatures and specific humidity of air in condensed space. And rise the dew point temperatures of the air in the condensed space. So we know that sensible means they are only related with the temperatures. Okay, and if latent is come, then it is related with the phase change process. Okay, phase change means it is water is converted into the ice and water is converted into the vapor. It is called as the phase change process. Okay, so when the sensible is come, then it is only affect to the dry bulb temperature. So option A is the correct answer. Suppose here the latent heat load is asked, okay, then they affect the or rise the specific humidity of the air in a condensed space is there. Estimation of heat transfer rate through the building is complex. Means when we do the load calculations, we need to calculate the how amount of the load is enter from the wall, four side wall of this room, as well as from the terrace surface. Okay, so that calculations we need to the heat transfer rate, overall heat transfer rate that you study in a thermodynamics, sorry, in a heat transfer. Okay, so what are the reasons that it is to be complex? The complex structure of wall and roof, considering of it wide variety of materials, varying indoor and outdoor conditions, and larger size of the building, and both A and B. Okay, now correct answer is both A and B. Why? So we know that our wall have a different layers. So first it is outside layer of colors, then layer of plasters, then after layer of bricks, then inside again the layer of plasters and layer of colors. So all these layers have some different thermal conductivity, have different thickness. So it's make the calculation of overall heat transfer is difficult. Okay, so point number one is also correct. Point number B, varying indoor and outdoor condition means at the morning 6 a.m. outside condition is different, room condition is different. At the 7 it is different, 8 different, at the 12 p.m. it is different, 2 p.m. it is different. So it is a continuously changes. Okay, so these things have make the complications of the calculating of the heat transfer rate of the wall of the building. Which of the following is not the latent heat gains? Okay, so option A is the lighting, option B ventilation and infiltrations, option C occupant body, and the option D cooking foods, packing and the boilings. Now what is the latent heat? When the something, some product or some humans are rejecting the heat to the atmosphere by rejecting it, at that time the vapor is coming inside the rooms. Okay, so lighting means our tube lights. Okay, different fans. So when this light is on, they are not rejecting any water vapor particles because it's only just increase its temperatures. Okay, so after the few times or 15, 20, 30 minute or 1 hour, light is on and we touch, we feeling the, that is a hot surface of the lights. Means they are only reject to the sensible heat. What is ventilation and infiltrations? Means the air enters outside. Air enters inside the room from the outside. That is called as the ventilations and the infiltrations. So that where that air enter inside the room have some water vapor, so they affect to the latent heat. Occupant's body means our human body also remove the heat in a form of sensible as well as the latent. Okay, so in our respiration systems, some of the water vapor particle is also come from the our body surface. When we feel the perspirations on the our surface, means the small droplets in our screens, they increase the latent heat of the room. Cooking the food, baking and boiling, the water vapor is coming from cooking, so they increase the latent heat. Okay, so here question is asked not latent heat. Okay, so lighting equipments are not removing the latent heat. That type, this question is also asked, which of the following is only the source of the sensible heat gain source? So again, the answer is coming the lighting. So this type of the MCQ is asking by changing the different questions. Heat transfer through the building can be considered as a steady if, that's the various answer is given. Variation in outdoor conditions with time are not significant. Variation in indoor conditions with the times are not significant. So these different options are given, okay. And what is the correct answer is the option D. Means all of the above are the correct answer. Because the heat transfer from building can be considered as a steady. For considering the steady, number of things are required. Means we require the outdoor conditions same. Means they are not need to change. Indoor condition are not changed. Thermal capacity of the building walls are too large. Okay. So all these factors are affect if you want to make the steady considerations. So all of the above are the correct answer. When the outside air is introduced for ventilation purpose, there is a sensible heat gain, latent heat gains, sensible heat gain as well as latent heat gains and none of these. So earlier I already explained, when the ventilation air is coming inside, it have some higher temperature compared to room. Suppose room temperature is 26, outside temperature is 35. So when you open the window, some air is enters inside the rooms. So its temperature is higher as well as humidity is different. So they are increasing both sensible as well as the latent heat gain of the air. The human body is cool space, consists of cooling load of sensible heat only, sensible heat and latent heat, and none of these. So our human body also rejecting both the heat, sensible heat as well as the latent heats, because our body temperature is different, room temperature is different. Our respiration system removing some exhaust gases like a CO2, with that some water vapor is also coming, and due to the respiration systems of the our body, latent heat is also increased. So this increase the both sensible as well as the latent heats. Okay, now another MCQ is also asked, how amount of the total heat rejected by the human being in idle condition, in sleeping conditions. So here I show you, it is one table. So sleeping, when the human is sleeping, at that time their body rejecting 70 watt of energy. Okay, when it is seated, it is the 100 watt. When it is standing, 150 watt. When the walking at 3.5 km per hour, 305 watt amount of heat reject. Then office work, when doing the office work, they are rejecting 150 watt. When teaching, 175 watt, and industrial work 300 to 600. So this is the total. Out of this total, some is sensible and some are latent. So here sensible heat gain fraction is 0.75, means out of 70, near to 50% is sensible and 20% are the latent heats. So this type of the MCQ is also possible to ask in the examinations. Now before moving ahead, I request to like the video and subscribe the channels for watching the more video related to RSE as well as for the mechanical engineering. The various links are provided in the descriptions for the RSE video. For other subject like IC engines, you need to visit the playlist. For air conditioning, the operation theater in a hospital, the percentage of outside air in air supplied. Okay. So generally in our split air conditioning system, okay, that is installed in our room, they are continuously recirculate the room air. Okay. They are not taking the fresh air. So at that condition, in split air conditioning, we are feeling the suffocating after 8 or 10 hours because there is a oxygen percentage is reduced inside the rooms. Okay. But in hospital, how amount of the fresh air is required, means outside air is called as the fresh air. Okay. It is 0, 20%, 50%, or a 100%. So answer is the option D, 100%. Okay. So recently you know that in COVID case, the hospital, the Ministry of the Health are saying to not work the air conditioning system in hospitals. Okay. Because in some air conditionings, they are circulating the inside air. They are not carrying the 100% fresh air. Okay. So what happened? The COVID virus is come in the air and the air is taken back. Because in a central air conditioning, the return duct is putted. Okay. This return duct take the air, they pass from the evaporator, and this air is supplied in some another room. Okay. So that's why the cases are start to increasing in that cases. That's why the return air duct are closed in a central air conditioning. Then we are able to avoid this increasing of the COVID case into the hospitals. Which of the following statement is true? So various option is given here. And the option A is the correct. The penetration is important in building as it provides the visual communications to the outside world. The functions of ventilated air is to dilute the odors inside the occupied space, to maintain the CO2 concentration at satisfactory levels, to pressurize, escape the route in event of the fires, and all of the above. The correct answer is the option D. All of the above are correct. Okay, because ventilation is at the freezer inside the rooms, so they are able to dilute the odors levels inside the occupants, maintain the CO2 concentration means they reduce the CO2 levels because the fresh air is come means oxygen is come, so CO2 concentration is reduced. Okay, and pressurize escape routes in event of the fire. That's why the ventilations are required. The uncontrolled entry of untreated outdoor air directly into the condensed space is known as ventilations, infiltrations, pressurizations, and none of the above. So it is called as the infiltration. Uncontrolled means we are not able to control. Means infiltration is coming for there is a space between the wall and the door, space between the window and the wall. So when you seeing that is a small crack is seen in between the wall and door, wall and window. So the some amount of the fresh air is continuously coming from these minor spaces. This is called as the infiltrations, and we are not able to control it. That's why it is called uncontrolled. Now, what is the stack effects? So here various option is given for the stack effect, and the option C is the correct answer. Means stack effects depend on the temperature difference between the indoor and outdoor conditions. Due to stack effect, what happens? So where is the different option is given, and the answer is option A. Okay. Due to stack effect, in winter, outdoor air enters from the opening provided at the base of the building and leaves from the opening provided at the top of the building. That is called as the stack effect. Which of the following statement is true? Ventilation is required for supply of oxygen for breathing only. Ventilation is uncontrolled while infiltration is controlled. Ventilation is requirement depends on occupancies and also in the activity level and all of the above. So answer is the option C. Okay. So here the ventilation is controllable and the infiltration is non-controllable. So this sentence is wrong. Okay. We are able to control the ventilations and infiltration is not in our hands. Ventilation not only supplied the oxygen for breathing, that MCQ is already covered. Ventilation requires depend on the number of occupants present in a space and which type of activity they are performing. Okay, suppose the in a college or a schools the people are seated. Okay, so they are rejecting less heat, so they are required a low ventilations. Okay, suppose we are talking about in gym, so they are doing the higher activity, so they are required a more ventilations. So option C. CLTD stands for means what is the full form of the CLTD? Various option is given A, B, C, D. Okay, and the correct answer is the option A, cooling load temperature difference. Okay, no, it is not logarithmic temperature difference, it is not deviations. Okay, the CLTD means cooling load temperature difference, means they are finding the temperature difference between inside and outdoor temperature difference. It is called as the CLTD. What is the ICL? ICL means instantaneous cooling load on air conditioning equipment is always less than IHG means intense heat gains. So our building materials is absorb some heats and we start the air conditioning systems. Okay, so what amount of the heat already present in building material, that is called as the IHG, and what amount of the cooling load or a heat energy removed from the space, it is called as the ICL. So which one is higher? Okay, that is covered in next MCQ, but here it is different type. So here the option B is the correct. Heat inertia of the building materials, that I already talked that the building material is stored the energy. Okay, then after they rejecting. So generally what happen at the 12 pm to 4 pm our terrace is absorb lots of heat energies. Okay, then after what happen at the night at 9 pm we start the fans and we are feeling too heat, but because So our slave is removing this heat energy inside our room. That's why we feeling so much of the heat energy, because in the nights outside temperature is even cooler, but we are feeling the heat energy in a room because our building materials are rejecting heat inside the rooms. Okay, so this heat energy absorbs by the building material, it is called as the IHG. ICL, instantaneous cooling load on air conditioning equipment, is always less than IHG, more than IHG, equal to IHG, and may more or less. So option A is correct. ICL on air conditioning equipment always less than the IHG. What is ACH? ACH means air change hour is equal to, means after some times we require to supply the fresh air. It is called as the ventilations. Okay, there I show you the results, because to control the odors, to reduce the concentration level of the oxygen, we are required to supply the some of the fresh air inside them. So generally that is a lots of occupant is there, then the ACH is 0.6 meter cube per minute of the fresh air required per person. Okay, this type of MCQ is also possible. What is the ACH amount for the human being? It is a 0.6 meter cube per minute. Here they talk to the find out what is the name is that. So ACH means air flow rate per volume of the room. Okay, means suppose our room is a 1 meter cube. Okay, then we require 0.6 meter cube of fresh air. Okay, suppose our room is the 100,000 meter cube, then we require the 0.65 multiplied with 100. Okay, that is a 65 is required. 65 meter cube per minute fresh air is required. So thank you for watching this video. If you learn, then like the video, subscribe the channel, comment on the video, and don't forget to share with your friend.